Dolphins are the deadliest large land mammal on the planet. It's estimated that hippo attacks kill 500 people each year in Africa. This is because they are very aggressive and territorial. If you enter their part of the river, they will charge at boats and capsize them. Once in the water, you'll be crushed or bitten and drowned. If you're able to get out and run, they will probably catch you as they reach speeds up to 20 miles per hour. Besides humans, hippos are known to attack lions, hyenas, and crocodiles. It would be easy for an adult hippo to kill a whole pack of lions or hyenas. Meerkat dictators, or mean girl meerkats, are alpha females that dominate their packs. They have been found to have up to twice the amount of testosterone compared to their male counterparts. These females rule their mobs with an authoritarian style. They steal food from others and pick their mates whenever they want. They dictate the jobs and reproductive rights of all subordinates, which is usually around 50. If any other females in the group manages to give birth, the alpha female murders the babies and gives the mother two options: leave the colony or earn their keep looking after her offspring. Meerkats appear to be the only known animals to have the conventional sex hormones reversed. Simophoa exigua, or the tongue-eating louse, is a crustacean parasite. This parasite enters fish through its gills and then attaches itself. The female attaches to and destroys the fish's tongue. Then it reattaches itself to the stub of what was once the tongue and becomes the fish's new tongue. The fish is able to use the parasite just like a normal tongue. It appears that a louse does not cause any other damage to the host fish. Once it replaces the tongue, some parasites feed on the host's blood, while many other feed on fish mucus. This is the only known case of a parasite replacing the function of a host organ. When a giant hornet invades a honeybee hive, hundreds of bees surround the intruder and create what's called a heat ball. With the hornet caught in the middle, the heat goes up and the oxygen goes down. The quivering muscles of so many bees cook the predator to death at up to 47 degrees Celsius. But what is really dangerous to honeybees is when the hornets attack in groups. As a last resort, when the bees sense a threat nearby, they begin to collect animal dung and put it at the hive entrance as a kind of shield, which sometimes deters the giant hornets from entering. These behaviors have only been observed in Japanese honeybees. European bees have not yet evolved to protect against hornet attacks. If a frog eats something toxic, it cannot vomit to eject its stomach contents. Instead, the frog throws up its entire This is called full gastric immersion. The frog wipes clean the stomach hanging out of its mouth with its front feet to remove any stray parts. Then it packs the whole thing back into its body, into its original position. Some goats have been genetically modified to produce spider silk within their goat milk. Golden orb weaver spider silk is among the strongest substances known to man, 5 times stronger than steel, and this method allows us to collect large quantities of the silk. We use it to make bulletproof vests, violin strings, medical bandages, optical fiber cables, and fancy clothes. Goats were used in a form of medieval torture called goat's dung. The victim's legs were tied to a tree, and the soles of their feet were covered in salt water. A thirsty goat would then lick their feet until the flesh was worn away. Most toads typically lay their eggs somewhere in the water. However, the female Suriname toad holds her eggs in holes within her back until they are ready to hatch. They can average 60 to 100 eggs per breeding, and the skin begins to resemble a pus-filled irregular honeycomb. When the eggs are ready to hatch, the babies begin to punch their hands through the holes until they are free. In a short time, up to 100 fully formed toads will come out of their mother's skin. They are not tadpoles. They actually come out as toadlets. The larval tadpole stage occurred in the mother's back before hatching. This method allows the offspring to head out and find their own food immediately. They will not require any further care from their mother. If you have trypophobia, look away now. Since the 1950s, at Overton Bridge in Scotland, there are over 300 some fish, shark, worms, and eels. Fossil records suggest that insects emerged around 400 million years ago, before the dinosaurs. However, they were not as small as they are today. They were giant. For example, Arthroplura was of the millipede family and grew up to 8 feet in length, making it the largest known land invertebrate to ever exist. Meganeuropsis, a relative of the dragonfly, had a wingspan of 28 inches. Chaecalopterus, of the scorpion family, although not an insect, would reach 8 feet long. Castoreum extract has long been used as a flavoring and fragrance ingredient in ice cream, cigarettes, and perfumes. Castoreum is the yellowish secretion of a beaver's castor sac, which is basically the bladder they use to mark their territory. It's full of anal liquids and urine, all mixed together. Petting a bird on its back, tail, or under the wings can cause it to see you as a reproductive partner, which may lead it to become sexually frustrated, resulting in harmful behavior towards you. Starfish have a feeding method that is unlike any other. To eat, it ejects its stomach from its own body, placing it over the digestible parts of its prey, typically a mussel or clam. The stomach then partially digests what it can, producing a chowder-like substance that is then drawn back into the starfish's 10 digestive glands. Brood parasites are animals that trick others into raising their young. Their strategy appears among birds, insects, and fish. Of all the birds in the world, none may be as clever and cruel as brood parasites. There are around 100 parasitic bird species who dump the eggs into another species' nest to avoid wasting their time and energy on childcare. Their life strategy is built on tricking other birds. Once the parasite's egg hatches, often the chick's first act is to get rid of their adopted siblings. An example is the newborn honeyguide chicks, who are equipped with deadly hooks on their beaks. Immediately after hatching, they stab and kill the other non-honeyguide chicks in the nest. All clownfish are born male. A clownfish group consists of a dominant male, a dominant female, and up to 4 juvenile males. So, where did the female come from in the group? When the female dies, the dominant male changes its sex to become the dominant female, and one of the juveniles then becomes This exchange takes about 30 days from when the female dies. Some herbivorous animals, such as hippos and deer, have been observed eating meat. Deer have also been spotted eating other deceased deer. Ambergris is a highly sought after ingredient used in perfume and can sell for thousands of dollars. Ambergris is sperm whale vomit. In 2021, a Yemeni fisherman stumbled upon a 280-pound chunk inside the belly of a dead whale. They sold it for $1.5 million. Jellyfish are 98% water, and if left stranded on land, they will eventually evaporate in the sun. The horned lizard defends themselves from certain predators by shooting blood from their eyes. Baby koalas, called joeys, eat their mother's poo. For the first 6 months after they're born, they drink milk from a teat in their mother's pouch. Then, for several weeks, they eat their mother's fecal matter. It is crucial for them to do this, as the feces contains special gut bacteria they need to survive on their highly specialized diet of eucalyptus leaves. Without this bacteria, they would not be able to digest the leaves. Koalas urinate, defecate, and give birth through the same orifice. Male platypus have spurs on their hind legs, which secrete a powerful venom that contains over 80 different toxins, similar to that of venomous snakes, lizards, and even spiders. While this venom is not fatal to humans, it would cause days of immediate, sustained, and devastating pain that's resistant to morphine and other painkillers. One Vietnam War veteran described the pain as worse than being hit by shrapnel. Victims experience nausea, gastric pain, cold sweats, lymph node swelling, and muscle wasting. However, Australian scientists recently discovered that platypus venom contains a hormone that could potentially aid in diabetes treatment. Golden dart frog contains enough poison to kill 20,000 mice or 10 people. It is just 2 inches in size and probably the most poisonous animal on earth. It is so toxic that just by touching it, it can kill an adult human. Cutter sharks are small sharks which reach around 50 centimeters in length. They eat by taking bites out of any medium to large sea creature. It feeds by first securing itself to the body of its prey by suctioning its lips to secure a seal. Then shark rotates its body to cut a complete circle out of the animal, leaving a round crater-like wound about 5 centimeters across and 7 centimeters deep. Cockroaches have been recorded to eat human flesh of both the living and the dead, although they are more likely to take a bite of fingernails, eyelashes, feet, and hands. In 2018, a bedridden woman in Georgia was found half decomposed, crawling with maggots and cockroaches. She was still alive. The report said her legs were completely black and showing signs of active decomposition. The maggots and roaches were attached to her and eating her flesh. Otters are not as cute as you might think. In the wild, adult male otters will rape baby seals, usually killing them. When mating with female otters, they will be brutal, biting their face, which sometimes kills them, before also performing necrophilia. Bed bugs mate by traumatic insertion, which means that the male penetrates the female by piercing into her stomach and ejaculating directly into that wound. This allows the sperm to get close to the ovaries. However, the wound may get infected. In some places, more than 20% of armadillos are infected with leprosy. They are naturally infected with the bacteria that cause leprosy in people, and it may be possible that they can spread it to humans, although the risk is low. Deep sea male anglerfish are sexual parasites. They are not hunters and can only exist if they mate with a female. Because the fish are natural owners and the ocean is so large, they often starve to death as virgins. If they find a mate, the male quickly bites the female and fuses himself to her body. His fins and eyes and some internal organs melt away, and he lives the rest of his life attached, feeding on her blood supply and superior hunting skills. At first, scientists wondered why there were so many female fish and no males, until they realized the much smaller male fish was actually attached to her body. Anteaters have poor vision, poor hearing, and no teeth, and yet they can be deadly. In a 2014 report, an anteater attack left one hunter dead in northwest Brazil. 2 years before that, another man was killed in a similar confrontation. Giant anteaters, which live in South America and Central America, can grow up to 7 feet long. They can kill jaguars. Sicilians are legless amphibians that evolved 100 million years is filled with dozens of needle-like teeth. One species of Sicilian feeds its young by growing an outer layer of skin high in fat and other nutrients, which the young will eat. A new skin layer will grow every 3 days for this purpose. European catfish are 1 to 1.5 meters long. They're the largest freshwater fish on the continent, and they hunt pigeons. They do this by lunging out of the water, grabbing a pigeon, and then wriggling back into the water to swallow their prey. In the process, they strand themselves on land for a few seconds. Dolphins are sexually aggressive and have assaulted humans. Bottlenose dolphins team up with 5 other males in order to capture a female dolphin and mate with her for a few weeks. Male dolphins kill their own babies in order to mate with their mothers. It is believed that the mother becomes ready for mating if their babies are killed. They have been seen using eels and other fish to masturbate. The dolphin's penis is prehensile, meaning it's capable of grasping and holding. Off the beaches of Virginia and Scotland, baby porpoises washed up dead with horrifying internal injuries. It was discovered that dolphins had been using echolocation and pulping techniques to internally damage and kill baby porpoises as a sport. Dolphins have their own territory and a hierarchy within the group. They are divided into several groups for different missions, such as raiding other groups to steal their females. Sometimes they hunt in groups of 1,000 or more, communicate their tactics with each other. Some studies have suggested they are second only to humans on intelligence. The orca, or killer whale, is the largest member of the dolphin family, and they kill great white sharks. In the 1990s, a killer whale was seen ramming a great white shark. It brought it to the surface upside down, then swam around with it for 15 minutes before beginning to eat it, effectively suffocating the shark. Horsehair worms are parasitic worms. Their eggs are laid underwater, near vegetation, and unknowingly eaten by crickets and grasshoppers. Once inside, they feed on the nutrients from the host. After a few weeks or months, the parasite will affect the host's nervous system and cause them to seek water. Once in the water, it will force the host to drown itself. The parasite burrows out of the host's body and into the water to lay their eggs and restart the life cycle. During the mating of honeybees, several male bees, called purpose is to mate with the queen. So even if he does survive this amputation, he will be ejected from the hive as useless. The female praying mantis chews off the male's head, either during or after mating, which can last up to 6 hours. Similarly, when black widow spiders mate, the female sometimes will eat the male. Some shark species practice intrauterine cannibalism, meaning they eat the other eggs while still in the womb. As the fetus shark develop their embryonic teeth, they start to eat the other embryos, killing their unborn brothers and sisters, as well as the unfertilized eggs. It's survival of the fittest inside the womb, until only one shark remains. Because of their pre-birth diet, they enter the world bigger than the other non-cannibal sharks. Some shark species grow very slowly, putting them in danger of being eaten by other sharks. Therefore, a baby shark's success in life is largely determined by its size at birth. Now here is one about us humans. I saw some of you were confused about this in the last facts video, so I'm going to explain it. Everyone on Earth is distantly related, and research shows it is very likely that almost all people are descended from Confucius. And in addition to that is the following. The common ancestor for every single person alive today, no matter where in the world, lived approximately 3,600 years ago. That means not only Confucius, but also Nefertiti, Socrates, and any figure from ancient history who had children, in some way is your ancestor. Doesn't this mean that Confucius had children with thousands of people? Well, Confucius only had 2 children. But let me explain. You have 2 parents, 4 grandparents, 8 great-grandparents, and so on. Each generation back you go, the number of ancestors doubles. But this number of ancestors cannot increase infinitely. There were never that many people on Earth. The further back we go in the past, the smaller the population was. So there must be a time in history where we can locate the common ancestor of everybody living today. When Confucius, Nefertiti, and Socrates were alive, the Earth's population was approximately 100 million. But no, they did not have children with each other. However, one day in the distant future, their descendants would. This family tree only shows 7 generations. On the top level are 64 ancestors. When you get to the 28th generation, the number of ancestors surpasses 100.